Welcome to another tutorial video. Today we're going to talk more about acrylic inks. You can add acrylic inks with isopropyl alcohol to create this really cool, crackly, funky texture effect in your pieces. So today I'm going to show you how you can manipulate that effect into a fading technique so that you get that really awesome depth in one area of your piece and spread it out. So first we're gonna have, like I said, our 91% isopropyl alcohol with a pipette, and the paper I'm using is a Yupo paper. And the brand of ink that I love is Dollar Rowney's FW inks. They are super fantastic, and they have a unique texture effect that's a little bit more dramatic than some other brands. So that's why I like them as opposed to some other acrylic inks that are out there. So first what we have to do is we have to mix it with a little bit of isopropyl alcohol. And I'll show you approximately the proportions here. So I usually take about, I'd say, 2 droppers full of ink into your cup, and again, make sure they're plastic, not paper. And then I take my isopropyl alcohol, and you just want enough to have the alcohol mixed in evenly with the ink. So only a couple of drops there, maybe, yeah, that's about good. So I'm gonna take another pipette, and I'm gonna mix it together and just make sure we have a nice even mixture in here. Yeah, that looks pretty good. All right, so once you have that mixed up, we're going to get started. So I have, like I said, my Yupo paper. So what I'm gonna do is just pick a point, and first I'm gonna show an example of how to do this without alcohol inks. We're gonna add that into another fade later, but for now we're just gonna focus on this pretty dark green acrylic ink. So I put a small drop of the acrylic ink mixed with the alcohol onto my Yupo, and I'm surrounding that acrylic ink in isopropyl alcohol, and I'm gonna be pushing the ink in and out of the alcohol, similar to my fading techniques with alcohol inks. I'm pushing that acrylic ink in and out of the isopropyl alcohol. You can start to see that texture is already beginning to form, and I want the area of density to be in that lower right-hand corner. So I'm going to add just a little bit more of the acrylic ink there because I want it to be a little bit more dense and also have a heavier texture than in the rest of the piece. This all adds to that really cool fade. I'm going to mention here quickly about heat guns. Do not use them with acrylic inks. You will burn your acrylic ink. If you use it at all, use it at a far distance and just to evaporate a slight amount of isopropyl alcohol if you're feeling impatient to move on to your next fade. I usually like to let these acrylic ink fades dry naturally on their own. So you can see sometimes you get a little bit of acrylic pooling, or you get these little, how do you describe them? The little crackly lightning bolts that come out of the ink. And that's okay, that's a natural effect. You can actually take a small paper towel and dip just a little corner into some isopropyl alcohol, and you can just wipe that up as it dries. So I usually babysit the fades a little bit to kind of modify it as it's drying if I get any of this effect in a spot where I may not necessarily want it. This fade has a really good example. You could see that little lightning bolt that came out of the top right corner, and I just decided to wipe that up. So now you can see we have one example of a beautiful acrylic ink fade on its own. So now I'm going to show you an example of how you can add in some alcohol inks into your fades. I'm going to be using N7 by Copic, and I'm going to use it to add a little bit more shading into our fade. This adds a little bit more depth, and you can also use this effect if you want to add other colors into your fade. So we're going to go ahead and start with a little bit of that acrylic ink. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to take that isopropyl alcohol, we're going to surround our acrylic ink, and we're going to push the ink in and out of the isopropyl alcohol here. What I'm trying to do is start to get that fade to form in the direction that I would like it, and also get an area where I can take my alcohol inks and add it to a spot where I want more of density. In this case, I decided on that lower left-hand corner, I added just a really small drop of that N7, and I'm going to be repeating the same process by pushing that alcohol ink into the acrylic ink and try and encourage it to have a cohesive fade. So I'm kind of happy with this, but I decided to add a little bit more of that acrylic ink, again in that lower left-hand corner. And then I also decided to add in more isopropyl alcohol. And you can know when to do this if your ink is not moving very well with either your breath or you picking up the paper. That just means it needs a little bit more isopropyl alcohol to help it scoot around. So I'm getting pretty happy with this. I have a nice fade with a lot of density going into that lower left-hand corner. Using Copics with your acrylic inks allows you a lot of choices with how you can add new colors, density, movement, and of course this beautiful texture using the Dollar Rowney FW inks.
You should see me in a crowd. I'm gonna run, there's nothing to help.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you learned a lot about acrylic inks, and I hope it helped you feel excited about trying them out for yourself. Check out my Instagram, AstuaryArt, or my website, astuaryart.com. Send me a message if you have any questions or ideas for a new tutorial video. Thank you all so much. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and happy creating. Bye!